Hello students, welcome to this online course of engineering mechanics. So till now in this unit we have seen what is the center of gravity and how we are going to calculate it for simple figures as well as for composite figures or composite shapes or composite cross sections. Now let us see what is the inertia. So in order to study inertia, first we will learn about mass moment of inertia, then we will see area moment of inertia or second moment of inertia. So inertia, the existence of inertia depends upon the reference axis. Without axis the inertia has no meaning. So mass moment of inertia of a body about an axis is defined as the sum total of product of its elemental masses and square of their distance from the axis. So let us say this is a body and this is the axis. So what will be the moment of inertia, mass moment of inertia of this body about this axis? So the elemental mass multiplied by the distance square. If we are adding all the small elemental masses multiplied by the respective distance square and adding them, then we will get the mass moment of inertia of this whole body about this axis. So mathematically what we can do, I, moment of inertia is generally represented by I. So I about AB is the axis, is equal to summation of dm is the elemental masses multiplied by the distance square. Or if the body is continuous, this is for discrete body, but if the body is continuous, then this summation sign will become integral sign and we will integrate this function r square dm, where r is the distance of element of mass dm from AB. So what is the physical meaning of this? Moment of inertia is the name given to rotational inertia, the rotational analog of mass for linear motion. So whatever role the mass is playing in the linear motion, same action or same role will be played by inertia when the body is in rotation or in rotational motion. So it is the mass analog of in rotational motion. The moment of inertia must be specified with respect to a chosen axis of rotation. So without axis there is no meaning of inertia. For a point mass, the moment of inertia is just the mass times the square of perpendicular distance to the rotation axis. Because for point mass only one pointed mass is available, so we will simply multiply it by the distance square. That point mass relationship becomes the basis for all other moments. So what we have done, we have expanded that point mass relationship. If the body is bigger or if the body, a continuous body is encountered, that point mass relationship becomes the basis for all other moments of inertia, since any object can be built upon a collection of point masses. So point mass is just like elemental area, elemental mass. So if you are able to define something for elemental area, then we will expand it for the whole body. So just I can relate the mass and inertia with some example. So this is for linear motion and this is for angular motion or rotational motion. So how we are going to write Newton's second law? Force is equal to mass times acceleration in linear motion. But for angular motion we will be calculating the torque. Torque will be I times alpha. I is mass moment of inertia. Momentum is, linear momentum is P, it is M times V. This is a vector quantities. Angular momentum is I omega. Kinetic energy is half mv square. For angular motion it will be half I omega square. If we are writing the work energy equation, so total work done, net work done will be F net into the displacement, which will be equal to the change in kinetic energy half into mass into v square. And for angular motion, the work energy relationships can be written as tau net into theta. That will be equal to change in kinetic energy, which is here half omega I omega square. So this is all about mass moment of inertia. Let us see one more important parameter, which is radius of gyration. So what is radius of gyration? For a planar distribution of mass rotating about some axis in the plane of the mass, the radius of gyration is the distance from the axis that all mass can be concentrated to obtain the same mass moment of inertia. So if a bigger body is there, let us say this is a body, this pen is a body, this is a big body, but what if I want to concentrate this whole pen, the whole mass of this body at a single point? So the resulting distance for that point mass will be termed as radius of gyration. So thus the radius of gyration is the equivalent distance of the mass from the axis of rotation. In this context, gyration can be defined as rotation of planar region about some axis lying in the plane. So K is the radius of gyration is defined by K. So mk square is equal to I, because the mass moment of inertia remains same for the whole body and for the point mass. So I will be same. So if K is the radius of gyration, then mk square will be I. So K we can directly calculate by root over I by m. Okay. So in the question, after calculating I, the examiner can ask you also for calculation of the radius of gyration. So this is the simple formula. Now let us solve some problems, then only you will get some feeling of this what is this mass moment of inertia. So the question is that determine the mass moment of inertia of a uniform rod of length L about axis normal to it. So axis is perpendicular to it. The location is given as first is centroid and second one is end. So let us solve this problem. So what is the problem? This is the uniform rod. Okay. So length is L. So axis is perpendicular. So this is something. The question is stating this is x-axis, let us say this is y-axis. So for this uniform bar, centroid will be at the center. So this will be L by 2 and remaining will also be L by 2. For first part, we are solving first part. The axis is perpendicular and located at the centroid. So what we have to do? We have to first take a general element. So we are taking a element, small element here at a distance of x. We are taking this small element from the axis at a distance x. Okay, and its thickness will be how much? Dx, very small element we have taken, so thickness is dx. Now let us calculate the mass of this element dm. So what dm will be? We have to see the before that, let me just write the expression for I. For this small element, I will be what? This is just like a point mass. So point for point mass, what was the expression? Simply x square dm. This is for a point mass, but for whole body we have to integrate what will be the unit, the limits of x. This is very important. So the x will be, this is the axis, this is minus x, this is plus x with respect to this y axis. This is origin, this is minus x, this is plus x. So in this direction the body is till L by 2, and in positive x also it is at L by 2. Okay. So let us, so this body is linear body. So what we are doing, we are assuming m, small m, is the mass per unit length. So dm will be how much? M times dx. This is mass per unit length multiplied by the length. So I will be from minus L by 2 to L by 2, x square m times dx. So m is a constant, x square dx. So I is m x cube by 3, and the limits are from minus L by 2 to L by 2. So this will be L by 2 cube minus minus L by 3 cube. So finally I is m by 3 L cube by 8 plus L cube by 8. So this will be m by 3 2 L cube by 8. So finally m is coming out to be m L cube by 12. Clear? So this is the mass moment of inertia of a uniform rod with respect to its centroid, the axis is perpendicular. Also I we can write as m L square by 12. M is total mass of the rod. Okay, from this relationship you can easily calculate. Now the second part is the what we have to do, we have to calculate the mass moment of inertia of this rod about axis perpendicular to the body, and the axis location is at the end. Okay, so this is L. We are taking a small element at a distance x of thickness dx. So again I is x square m dx, and this is dm. So now x is varying from 0 to L, simple. Okay, so m x cube by 3, 0 to L. Now m will be L cube minus 0 cube. So m L cube by 3 or m L square by 3. So in this way we can easily calculate the mass moment of inertia. What is the steps? First step is to assume एलिमेंटल मास एट सम डिस्टेंस, देन डिफाइन मास ऑफ दैट एलिमेंट, एंड थर्ड जस्ट यूज दिस इक्वेशन. ओके, सो इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल सॉल्व सम मोर प्रॉब्लम्स. सो दिस इज ऑल फॉर टुडे. थैंक यू.